Now let us discuss on the configurations of transistors. As we have discussed earlier that the transistor can be configured depending on the connections to the inputs and output side. For using a transistor for amplifier needs at least two terminals at the input and two terminals at the output. But this transistor has a three terminals, so there should be a possibility that one terminal should be common for input and output. On the basis of this common terminal, these transistors are configured into three types. The types are common base type, common emitter type, and common collector type. So let us discuss the first one, that is common base configuration. It is also called as grounded base configuration. You can see in the circuit diagram, the emitter to base junction, it should be forward bias, and this terminal, it is always connected to input side. So here the input voltage, it is connected to emitter base side in series with the DC voltage VEE. So this is the input side. About the right hand side, the collector is always taken to connect to the load resistance. That means the output is always taken from collector. So load resistance, it is connected to the collector and it is connected in series with the applied voltage, DC voltage at the collector. So VCC and RL, they are connected in series, and the output voltage collector to base is obtained between collector and base. You can see the input side is forward bias and on output side it is reverse bias. So this was all about the circuit diagram. Let us see what happened if the input signals are applied, what type of output we are getting at the collector. In this configuration, the base is common for both input and output, because the battery voltage or input voltage, it is connected between emitter to base and the output is taken across base and collector. So base is common for input and output side. The emitter base junction is forward bias and the collector base junction is reverse bias. Now let us see if input wave, it is connected at the input. Suppose the sine wave is connected here. During the positive half cycle of input signal VI, the forward bias voltage VBE, that is the voltage between base to emitter of the transistor, it will start decreasing. So therefore there will be decrease in the emitter current, and emitter current and collector current are nearly same from the transistor equation. So that is why the collector to base voltage, that is VCB, is given by VCB equal to VCC minus ICRL, and this voltage VCB is considered as the output voltage. So when IC decreases from this equation, when IC decreases, the VCB also increases. During negative half cycle of the input side, the VBE start increasing now. So hence there is an increase in the emitter current, and emitter current and collector current are same, so there will be increase in the collector current. This increase in the collector current causes there will be decrease in the collector to base voltage. Thus the input and output voltage will have same phase. So we can see when the positive half cycle is appearing at the input, there is a positive half cycle at the output, and when there is a negative half cycle at the output, there will be a negative half cycle. So we can say that the input and output are in same phase. The input resistance is lowest and the output resistance is very high in this type of configuration. In common base amplifier, the voltage gain is very high, but the current gain, it is very less, and it is less than 1. So this was about the common base configuration. Now the second configuration is called as common emitter configuration. So here in this configuration, you can see in the diagram, the emitter will be common for input side and output side. You can see the input VI, it is connected between the base to emitter, and output is taken across collector and emitter. So here emitter is common for input and output side. So that is why it is called as common emitter configuration. In this type, emitter terminals is common for both an input and output side. Therefore, the emitter base junction is forward bias and collector to base junction is reverse bias. The collector to emitter voltage, that is collector to emitter voltage VCE, can be given by the equation as VCE equal to VCC minus IC RL, and this VCE will be the output voltage. This equation is taken by applying the KVL, Kirchhoff's voltage law. Now let us see if input voltages are applied. Suppose the sinusoidal voltage is applied at the input and input's positive half cycle is appearing at the input. Let us see what is happening. So during positive half cycle of the input signal, the forward bias voltage VB will start increasing. Therefore, there will be increase in the collector current, as emitter current and collector current are same. So hence VC decreases according to the equation given above. Hence the collector to emitter voltage, you can see the equation VC equal to VCC minus IC RL. If there is an increase in the collector current, there will be decrease in the collector to emitter voltage. So during the positive half cycle, we will get a negative half cycle at the output. Now second wave, during the negative half cycle of the input voltage, the voltage at base to emitter will start decreasing. So there will be a decrease in the emitter current, and same decrease will appear at the collector. So the collector current also decreases. This causes there will be increase in the collector to emitter voltage, and that can be found by using the output equation VC equal to VCC minus IC plus IC RL. So therefore there is a phase shift of 180 between the input and output signal. As you can see, if the input voltage is positive, output voltage will be negative, and vice versa. The current gain beta in common emitter configuration, then voltage gain and the power gain, these values are very high in common emitter configuration. The values of input and output resistance are moderate, and this property is very useful in the amplifiers, and we can use the amplifier stages to connect one another, and this amplifier stages, when they are connected in series, are called as the cascade amplifier, and it is very useful in impedance matching. So that is why common emitter configuration, if you consider all the parameters of common emitter configuration, it is very useful, and the faithful amplification is given by the common emitter. So that is why common emitter configuration of transistor is very popularly used to construct the amplifiers. The third type of configuration is called as the common collector configuration. In common collector configuration, the collector will be common to both input side and output side. You can see in the diagram. But the load resistance RL, it is connected to the emitter. The output signal obtained in the emitter circuit follows the input signal, as the voltage gain is nearly 1. Therefore, these voltages at the input and output side will be same. So output follows the emitter. So that is why this circuit is also called as emitter follower. So common collector is nothing but the emitter follower. You can see in the diagram, the input is applied between base to emitter, and output is taken across emitter and collector. So collector will be common here, and output is taken across the emitter. Now let us take the example by applying the voltages. Suppose we have consider a positive half cycle at the input signal. During the positive half cycle, the input signal VI, the forward bias, that is VBE, that is base to emitter voltage, increases. Therefore, IE also increases. This causes an increase in the output voltage. So output voltage is nothing but the voltage across the emitter resistor, that is RL. So IE into RL will be the output voltage. So when IE increases, when VB increases, or there is an increase in the input voltage, there will be the current which is increasing and which is flowing to the load resistance. So the voltage drop across, the output voltage also increases. Similarly, during the negative half cycle of the input signal is decreasing. So base to emitter voltage will decrease. That will decrease the emitter current. So that is why the emitter voltage and the resistor where connected to the emitter, that voltage also decreases. So when input increases, there will be output which is increasing, and when input voltage decreases, output voltage also decreases. So the input and output will have the same phase. The current gain in common collector configuration is very high, but the voltage gain is very less, and it is less than 1. Power gain is as low as compared to the other configuration, that is common base and common emitter. The input resistance is high and output resistance is very low in this configuration. Therefore, this type of configuration, it is useful for impedance matching only. An amplifier having high output impedance can be connected to the load having low impedance. So this is very useful for impedance matching only. Now let us compare the common base configuration, common emitter configuration, common collector configuration on the basis of their parameters. The first parameter is the phase shift between input and output. In common base it is 0, in common emitter it is 180, in common collector it is 0. So only the configuration, that is the common emitter configuration, which gives the phase relation of 180 between input and output. And remaining configuration, there will be a 0 or same phase shift at the output. Second point to consider is the current gain. In common base it is less than 1, in common emitter it is very high, in common collector it is also high. Third point, the voltage gain. The voltage gain in common base is high, in common emitter it is high, and in common collector it is less than 1. The power gain, it is moderate in common base, it is high in common emitter, and it is low to moderate in common collector. So the power gain in the common collector is near about low. The input resistance in common base is low, in common emitter it is moderate, in common collector it is high. The output resistance in common base it is high, in common emitter it is moderate, and in common collector it is low. So you can see the comparisons of parameters of common base, common emitter and common collector. You can see the parameters which are very useful for the amplification and which are near about the needs of any amplifier are the common emitter configuration. So all the parameters matches to use that configuration for amplification is the common emitter. So mostly common emitter configuration is mostly used for amplification purposes. So this was about the comparison of configurations on the basis of the parameters.